να μπούμε στο επόμενο, στην επόμενη ενότητα. Θα πρότεινα να μην έχουμε, να μπούμε κατευθείαν, για να καλύψουμε λίγο χρόνο, να μπούμε κατευθείαν χωρίς διάλειμμα. Είμαστε OK. Ωραία. Δίνω τη σκητάλη στον συνάδελφό μου, τον καλό δημοσιογράφο, τον Μιχάλη Μαστοράκη, που θα συντονίσει το επόμενο πάνελ για την προμήθεια ενέργειας που ενηλικιώνεται και για την προσαρμογή των εταιριών στις εξελίξεις της τεχνολογίας και τις ανάγκες των καταναλωτών. Μιχάλη, έχεις την...
Σας καλωσορίζουμε λοιπόν στην τέταρτη ενότητα του συνεδρίου μας με τίτλο «Η προμήθεια ενέργειας ενηλικιώνεται, προσαρμογή σε εξελίξεις τεχνολογίας και ανάγκες των καταναλωτών». Νομίζω οι 5 εισηγήσεις που θα ακολουθήσουν θα ενισχύσουν περαιτέρω τη γόνιμη συζήτηση που έχει ξεκινήσει από το πρωί για την αγορά ηλεκτρικής ενέργειας και φυσικού αερίου, εστιάζοντας σε αυτή την ενότητα κύρια στην πλευρά της καινοτομίας και της τεχνολογίας, προφανώς με το βλέμμα στις σύγχρονες προκλήσεις του ενεργειακού συστήματος, προκλήσεις που δεν θα ήταν υπερβολή. Να πούμε όπως επιτάσσουν τη μεταμόρφωση αγοράς προμήθειας σε ηλεκτρική ενέργεια και φυσικό αέριο, τόσο σε ευρωπαϊκό επίπεδο, όσο και φυσικά σε εγχώριο επίπεδο. Με αυτά τα λίγα λόγια εισαγωγικά, να παρουσιάσουμε τους εκλεκτούς συνομιλητές μας στη συγκεκριμένη ενότητα. Welcome, Mr. Σιώτο. Mr. Σιώτο is Managing Director of Zenith. Hello.
Hello, hello.
Speakers also,
hello.
And I come back to you to begin our conversation. Μαζί μας επίσης είναι ο κύριος Κωνσταντίνος Ανδριοσόπουλος, καθηγητής ενεργειακής οικονομίας στο ESCP Business School. Καλησπέρα σας.
Καλησπέρα και από μένα. Σας ευχαριστώ πολύ για την πρόσκληση.
Καλησπέρα σε όλους.
Ο κύριος Ηλίας Πετρής, Διευθυντής Στρατηγικής και Επιχειρηματικής Ανάπτυξης της Energy. Καλησπέρα σας, κύριε Πετρή.
Καλησπέρα και από μένα.
Ο κύριος Δημήτρης Σαραντόπουλος, Διευθυντής Εμπορίου Φυσικού Αερίου της ΥΡΟΜ.
Γεια σας, κύριε. Καλησπέρα. Ευχαριστούμε πολύ για την πρόσκληση.
Και αναμένουμε, θα είναι μαζί μας σε λίγο και ο κύριος Δέτσης. Θα τον δούμε στην πορεία. I will not change to English in order to introduce our foreign speaker, Mr. Fulvio Sciotto, Managing Director of Zenith. Thank you very much for your participation. It's a pleasure to have you in our conference. Mr. Sciotto has presented a very interesting presentation of how the Italian experience can act as a model on the route to 2030 and provide us with experience and inspiration for our national energy affairs. Mr. Sciotto will present us the role of suppliers in this transition, taking into account that energy efficiency could be a fundamental step in tackling climate change and helping to improve quality of life. So, Mr. Sciotto, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Panagoulis, for your invitation. I'm sorry, but I apologize, but I don't speak Greek yet. I hope to speak very, very early. In my short and quick speech, I would show you the incentive policy of the Italian government for the energy efficiency and energy services within the program of the Recovery Fund. I try to. Okay. I share my presentation. Just a moment. Okay. I think we are ready. Okay. We can see the route of the recovery fund on energy efficiency. I show you the Italian experience. The route to 2030 of the European Council energy targets for 2030 are 40% of reduction in emission, 32% increase in energy efficiency, and renewable source to account for 32% of all energy consumption. Achieving this goal will help make the European Union increasingly independent in terms of energy. This is very important to enhance the quality of life of the European citizens. We can see the scenario on European and Italian Italian scenario. The European Green Deal it confirmed a key role of energy efficiency in decarbonization policy, with 55% reduction in emission by 2030 in order to achieve climate neutrality. About 35 million buildings to be turned efficient in the next 10 years. Less 14% of energy consumption and less 60% of climate changing emission. This is very important, this is the goal very important for our future. About the Italian, there is the next generation policy, is a temporary recovery instruments, more or less 700,000, 50 billions in loans and grants to respond to the economic and the health emergency caused by COVID-19. 28% of which is allocated to Italy, more or less 20,000 billion. And 37% of which shall be allocated to the green project. The National Resilience Plan under analysis, we can see in Italy the first drafting of its National Recovery and Resilience Plan reserved about 30 billion for energy efficiency and rehabilitation of private and public buildings. From this sum, almost 90 billion are allocated to the so-called 110% super bonus, and in particular to revive the building sector and the height of the pandemic, to extend the so-called 110% super bonus to the whole of 2022 for apartment buildings. 30 billions to upgrade low energy efficiency buildings in Italy gives a significant boost to employment market in the construction sector. This is very important for our economy to relaunch our economy. What are ecobonus and superbonus? Ecobonus and superbonus are the way that the government Italian incentive the process of the energy efficiency. It's the ecobonus and superbonus is a tax deduction for private taxpayer of a company such as a natural person and other several kinds of business company and private entities also. It's applicable when works to increase the energy efficiency of a building are carried on and in particular applies to houses, apartment buildings, offices and store and industrial building. It allows from it allow from 70% to 110% of the amount spent on the work performed to be recovered in the following alternative ways in 10 or 5 equal annual installments, which are offset of declaration of income. Be transferring this claim to the business which carried out the work through a discount on the invoice. This is very important for the customer, for the last customer, because the company takes the debt of the customer to launch these works. In this slide, we have, we can watch a big overview about all the products and the services that the Superbonus can cover. From the boiler maintenance to the security cameras, all the world of the IoT, all the world of the energy efficiency. The advantages of the offer are a lot, because every apartment building benefits from the tax deduction immediately, without waiting for the project 10 years. The savings of energy in relation to current consumption can go from 40% to 60%. The value of the real estate increases. Lower emission of CO2, and ensure that the tax deduction is available for the intervention. A lot of advantage for the our quality of life and for the value of our building and apartments. There are some barriers, some obstacles, but are mostly psychological obstacles, because the consumer consider the energy waste and its impact on the environment to be a serious but psychological distant problem. This is the first obstacle, the first barrier. But in this moment, is not so strong, because we start in 2070 with our campaign to increase and improve the energy efficiency on the building and on the apartments. We start with our products called Cappotto Mio. In English is like my coat, because it's a thermal isolation of the building for the building. The second is the mechanism for the tax incentive and use of the tax deduction require somewhat complex management and technological support platform. We made a very simple platform to resolve every problem for the customer. We can resolve every, we can break every obstacle, every barrier. We can make the project at the final without problem for the customer and for the enterprises. Last but not least, the citizen limited financial resources and the decision making process for apartment and buildings does not facilitate. Yes, but with the Superbonus, the government cover all the expense more the financial interest. In this moment, with the Superbonus, is very, very easy to renewable our it's our own apartment. Sorry. The numbers of Eni by Eni Gas and Luce is the only company in the country to have established partnership with more than 1,000 business, 800 on the construction companies, and the rest between windows and door build companies photovoltaic installation and other IoT enterprises. In this case, we relaunched the the world of employment in very, very strong, strong way. There is a huge opportunity to export the same model in Greece with, I hope, Zenit. At the end, quickly we can see the picture of the picture of the state of the heart of the buildings in Greece. Most of the buildings were built in between 1970 to 1990. In these 20 years, they build more than 1 million, 1 million of building, and all these building can take the incentive to the energy efficiency. To improve the energy efficiency, to enhance the energy efficiency. This is very important for the reduction of the emission, to the for the saving of the consumption, to increase the value of the home apartment or building, and to relaunch the world of the employment. This is very, very important after this moment, very, very critical by the COVID-19. I hope in Greece we can follow the same way, of the same Italian way. And sorry.
Okay.
I finished. Okay. And I hope we can start with the new age of the energy efficiency in the future.
Okay. Thank you. Thank
you, Michaelis. Thank you too.
Thank you for your presentation. It was really to the point. It gives us the big image where we have to reach, but more importantly, in which way we have to move regarding the energy market. Eco bonus and super bonus, I think, could be an example of what we are talking about. Thank you very much.
It's very important to have a strong help from the government, because in Italy, all started with the very strong help from the government.
Okay.
The incentive are the key.
You are right.
Yeah.
We keep that.
To open these doors. Okay.
The government. We keep that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Συνεχίζουμε με το